say?
What do you say?
Welcome to Grass Doors.
Grossy Meats blog.
This is the Path to the Draft, episode one.
Season one, this is the pilot episode.
Yeah. This is our road trip to Dallas to the training facility.
Today, we're making our stops to get the stuff that we need, stuff that he needs.
All right.
Break one.
So we are, what, 2 hours in? Yeah, shout out GSA, you know what I'm saying? Shout out Jesus. Shout out the Lord and Savior, you feel me? So yeah, we stopped at this Bucky's right here. You know, got us some...
healthy snacks.
Some healthy snacks. You know, I got 89 cent iced oatmeal cookies. This whole thing was 89 cents.
Round two. Aww. The baby moving.
What's up, guys? It's my little voiceover thing. This is cool. Yeah, so this is our Airbnb. Here's the dog. Beautiful young lady. This is our room. This is in Louisville, Texas. It was a really nice Airbnb. We liked it a whole lot. We were here for our entire first week in Dallas. So yeah, just got to the Airbnb. First time eating in 6 hours. In and out. I rate In and Out. What do you
get? 2 out of 10.
5 out of 10. 5 out of 10. So it's 2 5s.
No ketchup.
3.5 out of 10.
No Chick-fil-A sauce.
No ketchup. No sauce. Fries are either really flimsy or
extra crispy.
Dummy crunchy. Do the dance. Do the dance. Do the spin.
I only know how to. No, her shoulder.
Her puffo.
Let go.
She doesn't like her harness. She does not like it.
You feel me? I was trying to get a cameo with her, but. Alright, yeah. Alright, I'm going to bed. Alright. Outfit secure. Right now we're in Louisville, Texas. This is about 15 minutes away from where we'll be training. And yeah, we're just walking our dog right now. It's 10 a.m. Hey, Papo. Dude, got anything to say to the people?
Nope.
Okay. This is what... one of my favorite parts of the trip, just, you know, hanging out with the dog and Josie for the first couple of days. Didn't really have any, you know, thing to do but just have fun. This is a little game we play where I try to tackle her when she returns back with the ball. It's pretty much a challenge. We were tied at this point, 1-1. This is the final match. Who do you think is going to win this match? Let's see.
She got away from you again.
Sometimes the dog does this, whatever this is, and she just goes forever.
Oh, she's not done.
Ended up having to chase her through the mud and through the water to eventually get her, which got my shoes pretty muddy. And do the gritty, you know what I'm saying, to get the mud off my shoes. It worked though.
Good, some came off.
Went to this awesome place, another broken egg cafe. Was super excited. You know, breakfast is my absolute favorite meal. I'm a super duper omelet guy. So I was excited to get into this broken egg cafe in the Colony, Texas. So probably doing in COVID now.
Oh, look at that rock. Ooh, look at the glisten. Ooh, she taking. She's spoken for. Yeah.
Yo, we got these things for free. They was going stupid. I think it was called a beignet, a beignet, something like that.
Oh, yeah. What's that, babe? That's your new gang sign?
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. So show me what it is.
G-A for Jesus.
Yeah.
C for Christ.
Oh, yeah, that's hard. That's hard. Throw it up. Yeah.
A beignet. We figured out what that was called.
Shrimp and grits. French toast in the middle. Crazy omelet. Biscuit. Potatoes. Catsup.
As you can tell, the food was very nice. It's very good.
Where are we going?
Walmart. Right. How am I supposed to look at the directions when you have your phone in the place where the directions
are? I will tell you where to go. What? What?
No, I'll just figure it out.
Alright.
Welcome back to our channel, guys.
Alright, don't hit the cars.
My chest hurts. Hard time breathing.
Hey, bro, I'm kind of... What's up?
I didn't see it. It came out of nowhere.
Big old truck? It came out of nowhere?
Yeah, I didn't see it.
Stop looking at yourself.
I'm looking at the air. Try again. Please, can you fix it to where the air is blowing at me, not the windshield?
We are on the path to the draft. Right now.
Semlum.
Huh?
Semlum.
We are currently in The Colony, Texas, or Louisville, Texas, or Frisco, Texas.
Or Plano. In the colony.
So, looking forward to meeting all the colonists.
Colonization.
Yeah.
You know, it kind of reminds me of is the movie The Village. Have you ever seen The Village? It's based on a book. It's a really good movie. It's about this guy that, The Village.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, and like they're in like the national park, and they think that they're like way back in time, but they're actually not. It's weird.
And the boy, he has like a disorder or something.
I couldn't tell if he...
I'm just kidding, bro. I've never seen that one.
You 75?
You told me.
I said put it on my face. I didn't say put it on heat.
You put it on 69?
Yeah. You're gross. Don't look at him.
You know what a Walmart is?
Obviously.
It's cool.
You're doing your cool guy thing.
Let's put the cameras on.
Whenever Grant has to do something that's adult or really manly, he drops his voice and he's kind of like, that's cool. And he puts his tongue in the side of his mouth. Every time, it never fails. And I always tell him about it. And he's for example, I asked him when he had to be at the airport. He's like, you gotta be there like 6. That's what you do. It's his cool guy voice. It's what he does. It's really funny.
I don't do that.
Yes, you do. You were just doing it.
No, about Walmart?
About you said something. I don't know.
Walmart Super Center.
Come on.
I just sneezed at Walmart, and all of the old people looked at me crazy and backed away from me. So, yeah, COVID.
Boom, 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 boom.
Did you make my
editor?
No.
What are you saying?
I don't know, but this morning Josie has made me the breakfast.
Yes.
Oh. So the dog has eaten the rug.
Look, he can fix this.
At our Airbnb.
We can just look, I have scissors, we'll just cut deep, deep, cut those two off and it'll be fine. Because look, you can hardly tell.
Yeah, hopefully. You idiot!
You enjoying yourself? Sprawled out on the bed. You enjoying yourself? He did.
All right. Welcome back.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Guten Tag.
Guten Morgen.
Okay.
We're headed to the combine training facility called EXOS. And Frisco should be about 15 minutes away from here. I've already been there, but I'm gonna, you know, show you guys the outside of it, and I'll
really
show.
Just show me.
Yeah, I'm gonna show Josie the facility as well. So that's where we're headed.
And we're going on a lunch date.
Yes, we're going on a lunch date. To I don't know where yet.
Sushi. I want sushi so bad.
Yeah. You know.
I made you amazing dinner last night.
Alright, she made dinner yesterday and it was awful.
In my defense, I only shop at HEB and I only get HEB brand stuff, and I went to Walmart.
Look, bro, I didn't even want to record what she made because I didn't want her to feel worse than she already felt. But when I tell you that mug was so terrible.
I usually all the meals are always usually really good, in my opinion.
Yes, I agree. Except for that one.
That was the only one. I threw it away. I couldn't eat it.
Yep, sucked.
And it smelled.
And I replaced it with Dairy Queen ice cream. That's what I ate for dinner. Yeah, babe, I don't know where I'm going, babe.
Okay. Probably get on the toll road.
No.
All right. Let's not get on the toll road.
Put it EXO.
Okay. Go straight.
So I was supposed to get on the toll
road. Yeah, I told you.
All right. You just know where Frisco is at,
yeah.
In relevance to the colony, Texas?
Yes.
I doubt it.
Let's get chilies.
Nope.
Grant doesn't like chilies.
Nope.
Oh. Why didn't we go to Kroger yesterday?
Kroger does worse than Walmart. Kroger?
Uh-uh. Kroger is better.
You're thinking of Randall's.
No, Randall's is more expensive. Walmart is the bus down. All the grocery stores.
Kroger is the buzz down of all the grocery stores.
No, there are some really nice Krogers.
All right.
Better.
I'm tired of yawning, bro. Stayed up late, you know what I'm saying? Stayed up late on the game.
Till like 2.
I was on that Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, you feel me, on the Zombinos. I was killing all the Zombos. No, they was already dead anyways, you know, so it wasn't like I was just doing something that was uncharacteristic. All right, bro, I'm not going that slow, bro. What's up with y'all? Everybody,
you always drive slow.
Everybody passing me, huh?
You drive slow every single day. You're like a grandpa. All
right.
Every day you drive slow. On the way here, you were in the fast lane going 70 miles an hour. People were getting mad at me.
Because you were 20 feet behind me in your car, 200 feet, I couldn't see you.
It doesn't matter if you can see me, I can see you. It's all that matters.
Oh, I didn't want a car to get in between us and you were going slow.
Obviously, I had the map up. I know how to get to Dallas. Right.
The map. Ah! Toyota, y'all heard me? I'm trying to get that Tundra. Sponsor me. Give me a free truck, please. Please. Dallas has a knife. Knife.
Nice stuff.
Dallas has nice tollways.
Go.
Do you know, I gotta take you, they actually have the biggest bookstore in the world here.
Can we go today?
No, I'm just playing. I don't know if they have that. I was just...
a cotton gin.
We're actually in Cotton Gin Lane in Colony, Texas.
Oh, man.
This was certainly slave territory. 100% chance.
How do you know?
Cotton Gin Lane.
Cotton Gin Road.
Cotton Gin Road.
Road.
Cotton Gin Road in the Colony, Texas. But look at all this field, bro.
What are those cotton fields?
For sure.
No, they can't grow cotton here. It's too dry.
How do you know that?
I don't know.
All right.
Too many rocks.
Where did you come from? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe, at the end?
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? I've been married a long time ago. Yeah, try again.
There's
a star, and they're pulling it. Little children. Watergate, Pizzagate.
What are you saying?
Let the public know.
You gonna get us flagged.
Pizzagate is real.
Stop. You don't know what
Pizzagate
that...
is real.
Stop. What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. Okay. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. Illuminati is real.
Oh, right. What? Where am I going, babe?
I don't know.
Guys, we are at the facility. And Noelle, the dietitian, is going to give us a tour of the facility right now, and we're excited about it.
So yeah, this is Noelle, the dietitian. She gave us the full tour. She was really cool. This is one of the fields that we, you know, work out at. Those were the hot and cold tubs back there. So Noel explained to us that EXOS trains athletes in every single sport, even guys in the Army and the Marines and Navy SEALs, stuff like that. So yeah, it's just really cool to be in an environment like this and a structure like this. You know, the GOAT right here, the boy Russ. Don't even gotta explain what's going on in this room, you feel me? We getting it working in here, you feel me? Yeah, sure. Here's even more people they have playing professional sports now. You know, I'm trying to be up here soon, you feel me? Trying to make it to the big leagues, you feel me? Yeah, but the tour was super awesome. Noelle was super legit. She showed us the entire facility. Right here is the pretty much where we get our protein shakes and our meals. The little small congregating area that probably won't be used that much.
due to COVID stuff, probably get our meals and go. This is the PT area. This is my favorite area because they have all the stuff you need to get back right, to stay healthy throughout this whole process, which is super big for me. We even got the opportunity to talk to Noelle a little bit about the churches in the area, just, you know, talking a little Jesus, you feel me? So that was super cool. Yeah, all in all, great experience. Yeah, she pretty much just laid down the line of everything nutrition that was going on and how we could pretty much pick our meals. But, you know, everything we were going to be eating was going to be healthy. It was going to get me right, get me swole. Yes, sure.
Just got done checking out EXOS, checking out the inside of the facility till tomorrow. It's pretty cool. What do you think?
That was great. I think it's a great place to prepare.
Yeah.
Just listening to Noah talk and talk about, you know, the nutrition and just kind of the relationships that she said are really good there between the coaches and the staff and stuff. It just sounded pretty good.
And hopefully I get to, you know, get some shots of, like, you know, us actually working out. And get to show you guys, you know, some of the workouts, some of the actual food that we eat, and pretty much just how this whole pre-draft process is gonna work.
I would say this is a good 9 out of 10.
9 out of 10. 9 out of 10. That's nearly maximum satisfaction.
I know. You can see my lazy eye?
Stop.
You're totally smacking behind the camera super loud.
Yeah, I'm tripping. Oh, yeah.
See, man. Soda shoes, man. What do they got? So, yeah, that's crispy.
I'll see you later. Drive safe.
You want to say bye? Do you want to say bye?
Bye, Popo. Bye. Bye.
I'll just see you after the draft.
Well, I'm now alone by myself. I'm about to start the training process today. So today's my first day at EXOS. What's going down?
Here it is. What everybody's been waiting for. It's my boy Larry right here. Yes, sir. We're going to test our 40-yard dashes. That boy Garrett. We're going to test our 40-yard dashes to start it off. And we were chopping. You feel me? We were running as hard as we could. You feel me?
Let me tell you, nobody ran what they wanted to run, but Scooter ran fast, boy. But Colin Hill got out. Yes, sir. Now it's time for your boy. So I was not incredibly happy about my get out. As you can see, I'm pretty much standing up tall already. Didn't really get anywhere with my first step. Not really making any ground how I really want to. But, you know, Brent gonna get me right. He gonna get me right. And that's why I'm here, you feel me? But, you know, I was chopping a little bit, you feel me? But, yeah, didn't run the time that I wanted to run. But, I mean, it's day one. So, you know, quest to 4-5. That's the goal.
So with their official combine measuring system, I was 6 feet tall, 224.4 pounds, 11.4% body fat, which is really good for my position. I probably want to be somewhere around 228, a little closer to 230 weight-wise, but that's a really good body fat number. And getting that 6 foot instead of that 5'11 and 7/8 or whatever that some guys get. 6 foot just looks, for some reason, they think that's like a whole 4 feet taller than 5'11. So that'd be really good if, that's really good that I officially measured in at 6 foot. So we got some work to do. Yo, so I just finished testing my bench press, my short shuttle, which is my 5'10'5". And my L cone drill and my broad jump. So I did super duper duper good, way better than I was expecting in all of these. Like, I would be good if I tested at these numbers the day of the combine. I'd be like in the top, probably the top linebacker in all the categories except for the broad jump right now. So I mean, that was super awesome. Super good testing cycle right there. Really happy about that, especially considering this is just day one. I'm just looking forward to get better. So yeah, that's my little update after all my testing stuff. So y'all just pray for me, pray I stay healthy, and just keep grinding.
Yo, what's up? I'm in bed right now, just finished editing the video. So, you know, make sure you guys like the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on my notifications. I'm finna be posting crazy videos. Like, once every 2 weeks is what we're going for. You know, so this is gonna be the whole pre-draft process, whole path to the draft. They're saying the combine might even be canceled. That's all coming up on the next episode. So stay tuned. Stay tuned and lock in. God bless. Jesus Christ.